Since the departing of our king, you have revealed your most unbecoming nature. Gallivanting about with those harlot friends of yours. As his widow, you have a responsibility to conduct yourself with dignity and honor. Yet you walk with the widened gait of a whore.
As your queen, I am allowed to behave in any way that I see fit. Or must I remind you that this widening gait once enveloped and devoured the man that you call your king?
I see no queen. I see a filthy child dressed up in the trappings of a title into which she was not born. Your wicked tongue makes light of the whispers which would place a bounty on any other head.
Can't a queen mourn the loss of her beloved king in any way that she'd like?
You have maintained your innocence from the start, and you were allowed that innocence. It's a way to placate the public perceptions as we investigated the murder of our king. I and others are beginning to suspect that these may not be just rumors.
Oh, okay. So then you'll let townsfolk be the judge, jury, and executioner of a queen? You let the gossiping of peasants determine a queen's fate?
Does the royal blood flow through your veins? Are you in the direct lineage of rulers? No. Our beloved king has departed, and your title along with it. All I see is a common widow.
Make no mistake. The blood with which my veins carry may be common, but the child in my womb is all that remains of your royal blood, and all that remains of your king.
If the child you carry, the rightful heir to this throne, is a boy, then the court shall raise him up to be an honorable king like his father before him. If a boy it is not, it will be tossed into the sea. Regardless of the child's fate, you have defiled our court, besmirched the crown, and you will be executed for your treason and wickedness. You brought this upon yourself. Now go and make yourself useful.